Hello friends, welcome to Quick Glance Videos. In this video, we'll learn about flower androecium. Last video, we studied about parts of flowers. This video, we'll study about androecium. So, the main aim of Quick Glance video is to give you enough texture material, pictorial depiction, as well as examples. So, these three will help you to remember in exam and enough material to answer any question which is related to this particular portion. So, androecium. The androecium is a male reproductive whorl of flower. It composed of stamen. So, like in previous video of flower, we studied about androecium in brief. The stamen is composed of two parts. The lobe terminal part is called anther, and the slender stalk is called the filament. Anther. Each anther consists of two lobes. Connected together by a suture called connective. So these two lobes are connected by connective. Each lobe contains two cavities called pollen sacs, and pollen sacs or microspores are produced in the pollen sac. So pollens, that's a male gamete, is produced in the pollen sac. So we'll see the picture. All angiosperm anthers are bilobed and quadrilocular. So there are four locules are there. Sometimes anther becomes unilocular or one chambered by aborting one lobe, and two chambers get merged. So sometimes the two lobes are merged to form one chamber, and that becomes a unilocular anther. For example, in the case of family Malvaceae. This is a picture of anther I was about to show you. So these are the four locular, this is a line of dehiscence, pollen sacs and pollen grains. So in picture you will find like this, filament, anther, these are the line of dehiscence, and you can see four lobes in the transection. Now we will go into the classification or how various classification of the androecium takes place depending upon the size of the filament, depend on the anther, depend on the number of lobes, depend on the dehiscence. So we'll go into the details of that. So classification of anther. Intros, the groove ventral side of the anther usually faces the gynoecium or the central part of the fur. So when the grooved ventral side faces the gynoecium or to the ventral side of the or central side of the flower, is called intros type of anthering. Extros type, anther facing the petals. For example, Glaricia superba. So this is extros type. Anther is facing the petals. Division on the classification on the basis of shape of the anther. Linear anther, long, narrow with parallel side. Example, acalpha. So this is a linear anther example. Second is a rounded form. The rounded shape anther, which is found in Mercurialis. So this is a rounded form. So we are classifying on the basis of shape of anther. Sagittate is an arrowhead without flaring base lobes. The basal lobes attenuate to tails. Arrow shaped sagittate form. So the example is vinca. So this is the arrow form. It forms like an arrow. So the other form is sinus form. The peculiar S shaped appearance, for example, you mostly found in cucurbitaceae. So cucurbitaceae, you will find S-shaped the anthering. The other form of shape of the anther is reniform, which is kidney shaped. Common example is hibiscus. So this is kidney shaped, you find in this picture. And another form, it may form also from appendix. So the anther may also form appendix, for example, in case of Erica cinerea. So appendiculate type. So these are different division on the basis of shape of the anther. Now second forms are filament. So we have covered the shape of the anther. Now we come to filament. The filament is a stalk structure that attaches the base of the flower and supports the anther. It supports the anther, which is a structure to produce pollen grains. So this is filament. We have already covered in details. The filament. A filament may be devoid of filament A stamen may be devoid of filament, that may call sessile form. So there is no filament. The anther is directly connected to the base of the flower, as seen in trilium species. So this is a sessile form. A stamen may not develop any fertile anther, which is sterile and termed as stamenoid. So stamen may not develop any fertile anther, and which is sterile form, that is found in Cassia or Canna species. So this is the stamenoid. So no anther is developed, it's a sterile form. The filament may be white or colored, yellow, blue, black, etc. like petals. They may be branched as found in Renisius species, Renisius communis. Two forms are there, exerted filament, when filaments are long, stamens protrude out of the flower, and inserted, when the stamens are remain inside the flower. So this is inserted format, cryptanthinous and phananthrous. So this is filament going outside the flower. So exerted type. Filaments also sometimes bear appendages. Now we have covered anther, filament, and now the connective, the third part. The connective is the portion or the patch of tissues connecting the two parallel anther lobes. So these two anther lobes are connected by a connection, a connective in between. It is a prolonged of the filament and contains conducting strands. It contains conducting strands. And following the types, we can divide, classify on the base of the type of connective flower has. Discrete type, it is extremely small, anther lobes are very close to each other. So this is the example of discrete type. The connective is very small and the anther lobes are very close to each other. The example is Euphorbia species. You can see in picture. Divaricate, the two anther lobes are separated from each other. Example in lime tree and Frustica species. So this is the divaricate type. The third type is destructile type. When a connection is long, slender stalk like body placed crosswise. For example, salvia. So this is a long slender between two anther lobes. This is a stalk. So this is destructile type. Appendiculate type connective. The connective also may bear appendages. The connective is prolonged into a feathery appendix beyond the anther. So this is the anther and this is the other feathery appendages. For example, in case of Nerium odorum. So this is an example for this, and this is the picture for. Now on the base of cohesion and conation. What is cohesion and conation? The loose union of structure of same whorl is called cohesion. It's a loose union. But if the union is intimate and histological, or fully connected histologically, is called conation. Now on the basis of the fusion of filaments, the conation of filaments are found in different types of pollens. Now on the basis of fusion of filaments, we can divide the, we can classify the flowers also. Monodelphous, the fusion of one into one bundle, the filaments fuse into one bundle. So the example is Malvaceae or Milia. Didelphous, fusion into two bundles, Papilionaceae species. Podiadelphous, fusion into more than two bundles. So here is one bundle, here is two bundles, and it can be more than two bundles are there. Example, Citrus, Sermillae. Now, Syningaceous, when anthers are fused with each other. When anthers are fused with each other, filaments are not fused, the anthers are fused. For example, in case of Compositae, here the flower, the anthers are fused to each other. Synandrous, when anthers and filaments both are fused together. So anthers and filaments both are fused together. For example, in Cucurbitaceae. So this is on the base of the fusion of filament and anther, we can divide that particular flower into different forms. Now here is the picture for this. So this is Monodelphous, where example Hibiscus, you can see one bundle is there. Didelphous, two, poly more than two, syngenaceous, composite where the anthers are fused. And in case of anandrous, cucurbitaceae, anther and filament both are fused. So I think this is clear. Now adhesion of stamens. On the basis of adhesion of stamens, again we can divide epipetalous stamens. Filaments attaches with the petals. For example, in gametophyte, where the stamens or the filament gets attached to the petals. Epiphyllous, when stamens adheres to the perianth of leaves. For example, in tuberose, viscum. Gynandrous, adhesion between stamen and carpels. Here the carpel and stamen both are getting fused. Here it was stamens adhering to the perianth and the first one, epipetalous, it was with the petals. Gynasterium, where anthers fuse with stigma. In the example of orchidae. So here it's getting connected to the anthers are getting connected to the stigma. Apanthium or whorl tube, the portion of the flower found by fusion of corolla, androecium and or calyx. So it's a complete whorl tube is formed. It's a merger of or fusion of corolla or androecium or calyx. Now based on the attachment of anther and filament, how the anther and filaments both are attached, we can again divide, we can classify. So first is adenate type, when the filament is continued as a connective through the whole length of the anther and protrudes from the apex, in case of water lily. So this is the adenate type where the filament goes through the anther and protrudes out on the apex side. So this is adenate type, so we can see in the picture. The second is basific or innate type. The filament ends at the base of the anther. So here it's not crossing the anther lobe between the lobes, it ends. So in case of mustard seeds, so you can see it ends here. It's not crossing the complete anther lobes. Dorsifixed, when the filament is firmly fixed at the some position on the back of the anther, as in passion flower. So this is the anther, it's fixed in back of the anther. Unlike basifix, it's here, and adenate type is crossing the anther. This is the back of the anther, it is fixed. So you can see the difference in the picture. Now on the basis of attachment, we can divide now versatile type. Filament does touches the dorsal side of the anther. So the anther can swing on that particular filament where it's connected. So like in grasses, we find this, where anther is able to swing. Divergent type, when the anther lobes are distinctly separated due to elongation of connective. Example, tilia. Distractile type, when two anther lobes are placed very far away long by elongation. Salvia. This we have already seen. And distractile, where two anther lobes are connected by a very far away. So this is a connective is very long. So just to see the clear it in picture, so this is versatile type, as I said. So the anther can swing. So this is in connecting the back, anther can swing. Divergent type, the anther lobes are connected by branching type. Distinctly separated due to elongation of the connective. And distractile, as we studied earlier, it's a long connection is there. So hope this is clear. Now on the basis of dehiscence of anther, we can again classify. When anther becomes ripe, they burst, discharge the dry pollens. This act is called dehiscence, and the time when it takes place is called athesis. So the discharge process or the discharge of the pollen from the anther is called dehiscence. And how the dehiscence takes place, we can again classify. First is longitudinal. This is a common type of dehiscence where anther lobes burst along the longitudinal or vertical suture. For example, you find in Dhatura. So it's vertical. The vertical bursting of anther takes place. Now it has three types. extrudes the dehiscence towards the petal, for example, in ranunculaceae. Intros, dehiscing towards the ganglion. And now it's how the dehiscence takes place. It is divided into these three parts: extros, intros, and lateros, when dehiscence laterally in Orchidae. So these are three parts. And how the longitudinal dehiscence takes place, it is divided into three. Valvular, when the hole or portion of the valve of the anther opens out like a tap door, releasing the pollen. Examples in Barbarilis or Laurus, when a portion of that anther opens and the pollen is released. Poral dehiscence, the dehiscence by pores. The pores are two types: apical pore, in example is Cassia solanum; basal pore, the example is Erica. So now you can see in picture the intros type, the lateral stripe laterally, the extro stripe, the transverse, so it happens in middle horizontally, porous, the pores are here, and valvular type, it opens like a tap lid and the pollen grains are released. So this way, depending on type of dehiscence, we can classify the anthers. Now on the basis of position of the stamens, the position of stamens varies with their numbers. Isostramens, isostramens or haplostramens, when number of stamens are equal to number of petals, the stamens are equal to number of petals. Isostramens. So now this is of two types: antisepals, this is very common. The stamens are placed opposite the sepals, alternating the petals. I'll show you in picture also. Antipetalous, this is very rare. The stamens are placed opposite the petals, for example, in Ramiraceae or Proteolysiae, where the stamens are placed opposite to the petals. Diplostamens, when the number of stamens are double of the petals and outer whorls lie opposite to the sepals. So when the number of stamens are double of the petals, in first case isostamens it was equal. Obodiplostamens or diplostamens, where number of stamens are double and petals and the outer whorl opposite to the petals. So here the number of stamens are double the petals and the outer whorls lie opposite to the petals. In Rutaceae and Oxalidaceae. Polystamens, when stamens are more than two whorls. Example, Nandinae and Delphinium. So it will be clear in the picture. And the last type is fasciculated stamen, when fascicle is merely an aggregation of several simple stamens. So this aggregation of simple stamens and it forms a fascicle. So that's a bunch. Let's go fasciculated type. So here we see the antipetalous, antisepalous. So in the first form, in isostamens, they were antisepalous. This is very usual. And antipetalous. In antisepalous, this is placed opposite to the petals. And it is placed opposite to the petals. The first one is sepals. This is antipetalous and sepals. Diplostamens, epipetalous. And exerted, we have also already seen exerted and inserted type. Insert is within the flower, exerted outside the flower. So on the basis of position of stamens, we have divided, we have classified the flower. Now on the basis of length of stamens, if the stamen is the same length, but can be characterized on the basis of length. So diadamnus, when two stamens are long and two are short. Example, Liberate. Tetra Diamonous, where four are long and two are short. Here two long and two short. Here four are long and two are short. Heterostamens, where all the stamens are different lengths. So all different. For example, in Columelaceae. So now you can see in picture. diatomeous, where two are long and two are short. Tetra, you can see in cruciferae, and heterodimorous, where all are different, as found in legumes. So we have covered the different types of how we can classify androecium depending on stamens, filament, anther, the length of the anther, stamen, how it is the position takes place, and all the pictures to help you to understand the different types of classification. In the next video, we'll go through more parts of the flower, and do subscribe to Quick Glance videos and click on the notification icon so that you get update on the latest updates taking place. Quick Glance videos, we have textual part, the examples and the pictures in a simple form so that you can understand fast and use the content during the exams. Thank you. Good luck.